Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, a mathematics teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 2, Lesson 4, and the topic is indices and logarithm, and the subtopic is we are supposed to deal with index and index notation. On to the lesson objective, by the end of this lesson, you are supposed to define the term index and also index notation. And number one, the terminologies which are used in this lesson, we have index. What is index? Index refers to the power to which a number is raised from. Then index notation, on the other hand, refers to the writing of the number, that is the base, together with their powers. For example, we have 2 to power 4 is equals to 16. In this case, this is the index notation. 2 is called the base, and while the 4 is called the index or the power. The laws of indices, the first one, any number raised to power 0 is equals to 1. That is law number 1. In this case, we have a to power 0 is equals to 1. In this case, a represent an integer. Then we have a, that is second law, a to power n. Then you multiply by a to power m. In this case, we have a as the base and n and m as the power or index, and they represent also integers. And in this case, because we have a multiplication sign and we are multiplying this a common base which have different powers, you are supposed to write the common base as a and the power you are supposed to add them whenever you are multiplying any two numbers with the same base. You are supposed to add their powers. Then number 3, you are supposed to get a to power n. You divide by a to power m and the answer becomes a to power n minus m. And therefore, whenever division is used and we have a common base, you are supposed to subtract the powers. Then number 4, a to power n, then you raise the result. A to power n, you raise it further. You are supposed to get the by n, those are the powers. Then you have a to power negative n. Any number raised to power negative, you will get it as a reciprocal and the number, now in this case, become the denominator with the power positive. Then number 6, we have a to power 1 over n, it becomes the nth root of a. That is the answer. And we can see the application of those laws. 2 to power 0, remember any number raised to power 0 is equals to 1. And in the case of 2 to power 0, I write it 1. And then 2 to power 3, you divide by 2 to power 2, there is a common base of 2. And the power, because there is a division between them, you are supposed to subtract the power. And the answer becomes 1 times 2 to power 1, and the answer becomes 2. Then we have the second one, example 2. We have evaluate 2 to power negative 2 and 3 to power, you multiply by 3 to power 2, then you multiply by 2 to power 3, then you multiply by 3 to power negative 1. You bring the common factors together with the ones that have the common base. We have 2 to power negative 2, then you multiply by 2 to power 3, and you are supposed to add the power because they have a common base, and that is negative 2 plus 3. You will get the power of 2 becomes 1, and then you combine the other of the numbers, that is 3 to power 2 and 3 to power negative 1. They have a common base, that is 3. Then the power, you add them, 2 to power 2 plus negative 1, you get 1. And therefore, in this case, you will get 2 to power 1 times 3 to power 1, and the answer becomes 6. Example 3, you're supposed to evaluate the value of, to find the value of x, and in this case you're supposed to divide by 2 on both sides, and therefore you will end up getting 3 to power x is equals to 81. Then 81, you look for the factors of 81, and the factors of 81, it is 3 to power 4. And therefore in this case, because the right hand side and the left hand side, they have a common base, therefore you can get the value of x as 4, and therefore you drop the bases and you get end up getting x is equals to 4. Then our fraction of indices, we have 27 to power 1 over 3, and in this case whenever you raise a number to power a third, you're supposed to look for the cube root of that number. Therefore you look for the factors of 27, and the factor of 27 becomes 3 to power 3, and 3 to power 3, and remember the power is 1 over 3. If you you just group them in a group of three numbers, then you just pick only one of them, and that that is 3, and that the 3 becomes the cube root of 27. Then we go to the fraction of indices. Once again, we have the power in this case is negative 4 to power 1 of negative 1 over 2, and therefore you are supposed to apply the law that stated that whenever you are raising a number by a negative, you will get the reciprocal of now that number, and the power in this case becomes positive, and therefore you are supposed to look for the second root of 4, that is the second root of 4, that is the square root of 4 becomes 2, and the answer, overall answer, becomes 1 over 2. Then we have come to the end of today's lesson, and you are supposed to evaluate the following problems using reciprocal tables. The first question is 1 you divide by 0.00437, and the second one be 1 divide by 3729, and the third one is supposed to be 1 divide by 47.92. For reference, you can refer from student book 2 mathematics, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, if you'd like to clarify something from us, you can reach us at LMTV using the following addresses. You have the SMS using that number, the YouTube, you can also use Facebook, and finally you can reach us through Twitter. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, bye bye.